31-31 series continues. Today we're talking about the Ottawa Senators. Dan Rosen here, EJ Hradek there. Ottawa last in the league last year with 64 points. And they became the Toronto Maple Leafs this year.
Yeah.
Not really.
Yeah.
But the Battle of Ontario looks quite interesting. Ottawa gets a new coach, DJ Smith, who the last four seasons was on Mike Babcock's staff with the Toronto Maple Leafs. Nikita Zaitsev, Connor Brown, Ron Hainsey, Tyler Ennis, all played for Toronto,
yep.
All now play for Ottawa. And Artem Anisimov played for Chicago. He's now with Ottawa as well. So lots of changes there with Ottawa. Are they going to be any better with all these changes? This is a very...
I think they'll be a much more competitive team on a night-to-night basis than they were last year, because some of their young players have had a little experience. Remember, Brady Tkachuk had a really pretty good first year. Thomas Chabot
was terrific.
Really high-end young defender there. They're going to add Eric Brandstrom most likely to the mix this year. He was acquired from the Vegas Golden Knights in the Mark Strome deal. So I think there's reason for optimism with the Ottawa Senators. They are in a long-term rebuild right now, and there's some questions with ownership there, long-term, what's going to happen with their arena situation, where are they going to end up playing long-term. They got Craig Anderson in goal, the veteran, tried-and-true goaltender there. It's been there a long time. So he will be under fire because you have a young defense. But it'll be interesting. I mean, a new coach, DJ Smith, is someone that people speak very highly of. They do have some talented young players there. I just think for the Ottawa Senators, they're one of those franchises for me that there are no expectations really this year. So you go to training camp. It's likely a lot of us against the world mentality in that room, right? Mm-hmm. You know, nobody thinks we're any good. And you go and you have a good preseason and you try to get off to a good start. You just put your head down for 82 games.
Yeah,
I've said it before. You just put your head down and work for 82 games and try to get better. At the end of the season, you pick your head up and you see where you're at.
Yeah, look.
And I think that's the way you have to be if you're the Ottawa Senators.
And DJ Smith, I've heard he's an energetic coach, which will be good for young players like Tkachuk and Colin White and Brandstrom and a few others that they have there. He won a Memorial Cup with Oshawa, so he's experienced winning. Not as a head coach at the NHL level.
Yeah.
This is his first chance, but he's experienced winning. He's coached in the pressure cooker of Toronto, so he understands the Canadian market.
But he hasn't been the head coach.
No, he hasn't. He had to get
So it'll be important that he has real experienced assistants to help him with a young team.
Yeah, with a young team, you need that. So, but Ottawa needs so much.
That's the thing.
They need so much. But if you can get quality seasons out of some of the new guys, out of Zaitsev and Brown, Hainsey is a leader on the back end, Anisimov is as a third line, if not a second line center. Second line might be out of position for him at this point. He's not playing with Patrick Kane anymore, obviously. But, you know, if you can get that. But then you need to see the progression. I think a successful year this year for the Ottawa Center, progression from the younger players. Brady Tkachuk can be a monster player, as his brother is for Calgary. I think you got to see the progression there. Colin White, Brandstrom, Drake Batherson is another guy. Yeah. Thomas Chabot is an all-star defenseman. Can he be an all-star again? They've got young pieces there, and that's the success this season for the Ottawa Senators. Let's see the development of those
guys. That's right. Grow those young assets that you have there. And, again, the expectations are very, very low. They're worried about getting up to the cap floor, I would imagine, with some of the moves they're making. And it's a great opportunity for these young kids. And they're the kind of team with the talented young players they have is that you can't sleep on them. When you go to play the Ottawa Senators this year, if you sleep on these guys, they'll beat you just because there's a lot of natural ability there. They're just young. They're inexperienced. They've got to get a system in place. So that takes time. But I'm with you. I think a successful year is the continued development of good young players.
And I think what you said is important. The bubble over the team, I think, is important because there might be some apathy in the marketplace because they don't expect much out of the team. Quite, concerns are about the ownership situation and what's going on with that and the money that they spend. Fans can think what they want to think, and they will have their reactions and talk about it. But there needs to be a bubble over this team because that's how you get the progression that you need to see before that bubble is lifted, and all of a sudden in a couple of years the Ottawa Senators are looking like a contender.
They are positioned down the road to be much better, but of course a lot will depend upon how the ownership situation shakes out in the years to come. But a lot of good young players, not going to be in the playoffs this year in my mind, but again a team on any given night can beat you if you're not ready. Of course we could say that about all 31 teams in this league.
In this league we certainly can, but I think I agree, not a playoff team. But I think they'll be better, and I think there's reason to watch because they have some young players there in Ottawa that I'm curious to see their development.